First of all, thank you very much. So now I have 14 minutes to go over my slides about ECMA International Standardization. So as Turash has already said, we are here with different stakeholders, and I am one type of stakeholder, namely coming from standardization organization. And actually, we are a little bit different from the ordinary standardization organization, and this is what I am going to tell you in a few words. So let me go over what I want to show you in terms of presentation. So the first point is, you know, that how EPFL and ECMA International teamed up for this wearable 2016. Then very briefly about ECMA International. So we have also a slogan, standards and internet speed, which a little bit already covers in which sense we are a little bit different than other standardization organizations. Then last but not least, and this is what we would like to take out from these conferences, how to get involved in wearable standardization subjects. So we would like to get one part of the standardization cake if we can. And then last but not least, because you also have to conclude the presentation, there will be one slide regarding summary and the conclusion. So this is what I'm going to touch very, very quickly. And then the first one is, wait a second, how we have decided to team up. So EPFL, it is basically standing for education and research, as we know. So I don't have to introduce that. And research also includes standardization. So EPFL and Turaj and his institute, they were very much involved in multimedia standardization, which is in a sense a special type of standardization I will show you in a minute. And then here the other partner, that's ECMA International, so which is basically stands for ICT standardization. And then now I'm coming here to the other points, you know, what kind of standards do we have? And this is actually my own standardization categories. So there are first the classical standards. Well, it doesn't show it, but it is where the standards are development of is first, and then the standard follows, but somehow it doesn't show it. If I press it on my Windows computer, it did, and now it is ticking. Okay, so I have to tell you, I don't know what's going on here. Turaj, we have here a presentation problem. I have it here in the small one, but I cannot progress it. Okay, now it's come. Now it's come. Okay. Yeah, very good. So the second type of standards are where research and standardization goes in parallel and together. And this is for instance for JPEG, MPEG, multimedia standardization. And already on that category, there are a lot of problems within standardization policies and how to do it. And actually, one of the categories where ECMA can work rather well is the second one. The third type of standards, which is also a very, very small percentage of standard, where the development of a product and standardization, it goes in parallel. And actually, it is so far only ECMA that I saw which was able to do that. And to give you a concrete example for that, in ECMA TC39, which is doing ECMAScript or JavaScript standardization, as you know, the browsers, they are coming out, I don't know, four times, six times per year. And as soon as they are coming out and they are implementing the new versions, we are coming out at the same time once a year with the standard itself. So this is means an extremely good harmonization between standardization and between development of the product. And how to do that? Actually, I think it is only ECMA that from the standardization bodies which can, from the procedure point of view, really do it. So this is the reason why we have teamed up with EPFL, because our feeling is, and we don't know exactly whether this feeling is true or not, that wearables, which is a part of IoT, Turaj said that, it probably requires all the three different categories which I pointed out, but especially in category two and three, so we hope, you know, that we can take some advantages. So now let me get to the, this is now a very, very full slide, so most of them it is just for reading, so I'm not going through each of the points. So about ECMA International, that we are one of the oldest standardization organizations. Certainly we are one of the oldest in the area of ICT standardization. So we were established in 1961, which was earlier than ISO had its ICT group, and ITU had it, and so on. And actually we helped them to set it up. And basically it was an industry consortium at that point in time. And it was a European branch of it. There were also parallel in America and so on. So as time went on and the globalization started and so on, so also then ECMA adapted to it. And then we became 1994 international. So we have also a lot of membership from overseas, actually much more than from European one, which is a different subject. And became ECMA International. But since ECMA was the brand name, it was so well-known as European Computer Manufacturer Association, we didn't change that. And the topics of standardization, which earlier on, it was programming, hardware, software, big computers and their components and so on. So it became also much, much broader because telecommunication came to it, then also consumer electronics came to it, and so on. So if somebody doesn't know it and is interested, then you can go. So actually, these are the advantages, which I already, some of them points that I already mentioned. We are very, very small. We are very, very flexible. And we are trying, actually, like in a good Swiss Emmentaler cheese, we are trying to fill those holes where other standardization bodies have some difficulties in terms of procedure. So especially high speed, high efficiency, than the patent policy, software copyright policy. So those type of things, which are not a classical standardization organization doesn't have, but we have it. On the next one, this is how we are working. Again, I'm not going into every details. What is here important for us that is the speed of standardization, that the average for starting and also getting published a standard, it is 1 year. The absolute world record, at least in my practice, what we had that was from the very beginning to the publication, it was 4 months. It was on a subject which was for us extremely important to be very, very fast, so we did it in 4 months. And then, of course, there are standardization subjects which are not successful, then it takes forever. Or in this case, you know, I don't know, 9 years. So that was also one of the versions of the ECMAScript, JavaScript standard. So even that in earlier on. Let's get to the next one, which I already mentioned. And this is also more for reading for you. So which are those standardization components or policy components that other standardization organizations don't necessarily have and where we have our advantages? So first of all, we have the classical ones, which are basically defined by the World Trade Organization open standards criteria. So we are also fulfilling that. So there is, but regarding IPR policies, so patent policy, software copyright policy, which is extremely important in this area, and I'm truly believing also in the area of wearable for some part of the standards, so is that we also can standardized, for instance, royalty-free standards, which ITU, ISO, and so on, they cannot. They have a rent-based policy, so there is no guarantee, you know, whatever comes out at the end, whether it will be rent or it will be royalty-free. But we have a special mode, you know, we can switch between the rent and the royalty-free mode, which is, I think, very important. It is very important because internet, as you know, it requires royalty-free standards. So if you go to the World Wide Web Consortium, they have basically, I know, they still have. So they have basically royalty-free standardization patent policy. Then also software copyright policy. We have a clear software copyright policy that, for instance, ISO doesn't have any. ITU has also a very bad, bad one. So these are the additional components that we can offer. And now I can go very, very quickly, because this is an area where I just would like to hint you what ECMA tries to get out of this workshop. So this is, you know, what we at the moment we think. So certainly, as Turaj said, so the subject of wearable is extremely hot. So this is nothing new. So I can immediately switch on to the next one. We also believe that as a standardization organization, we are quite well established in order to get into this area. And then the next slide, just for reading, you know, what is a sensor and so on. I am not going into that because we are going to deal with this subject for 2 days. But what is here more important is that what we think that we may take out in terms of standardization subject. So basically, there will be no closed between, for instance, the sensor, they will definitely want to interwork with each other. A sensor with a server, one sensor with other sensor, and so on and so on. So here we find some of the areas where we suspect that we will have here some standardization subjects. So for instance, format of sensor data, then requirements for needed interfaces and protocols, standard interfaces, and so on. So here are some of the points. I'm not going into that because these are, as I said, it is just early guesses, you know, what we might get or what we hope to get. And last but not least, for instance, testing, interoperability testing. When the spatial area about which we are going to learn tomorrow in a presentation, so from the Swiss watch industry standardization, that, for instance, there are horizontal subjects which are extremely important. Nobody is dealing with them at the moment. So, for instance, environmental type of standard, environmental testing and aging standard around wearables. So there are a lot of horizontal areas which I think we can learn a lot what the Swiss watch industry standardization can teach us. They have many standards in that area. Okay, so these are the hopes. So now I'm coming to the conclusion, and then, yes, and then I will be ending it. So what are the conclusions? So first of all, we, as ECMA, we would like to learn from you what are the possible standardization topics. Then the next one is we would like to get some bright ideas for standardization and then take away. And then last but not least, we cannot do standardization without members. Yeah? So if it is only ECMA, only as a standardization body, then we have failed. But if there are some members who are joining us, or existing or new member, and then they are doing this standardization work, then we are already at the good side. So with that, I have finished here my presentation, and I was absolutely on time, Patrick. And so thank you very much, and I really wish you a fruitful workshop. I know we are calling it summit, but I thought, you know, that was a little bit high-flying. And I have completed. Thank you very much.